friends, family, colleagues, to acknowledge the work that you have completed and the successes that you have had. So I invite you now to sit back and to enjoy today's proceedings and to feel proud of your own accomplishments. I'd like to now again welcome the children of the Pesach for the dance performance. Please welcome children of the Pesach. Again, a big round of applause for the dancers and the children of the Basal. Now, for potentially his last time, I would like to welcome the director, Mr. Barry Sutherland, for his remarks to our graduating class.
Kinyum Savai Krileng, Dial Ban Jupnik Tiena Kinyam. Tanai Ni, Gia Augasla Orna, Samra Krusa ISPP Yung. Kinyum Mien Motanak Pia Krileng. Jumpua Sir Bonjap Witialai near Tanai Ni. Paon Paon Ban Comrien Yang Klang. Hawi paon paon nung ban jokje nul anagut. Kinyom song kum ta paon paon mok leng ISPP wing. Buntai, avai dial kinyom song kum klang jing ge gu paon paon chu manu atia. Well, here we are.
Every facet of life is dominated by numbers. Be it stocks, grades, bank accounts, the list goes on. In some parts of the world today, numbers are being used to define our behavior and what we as people may and may not do. Things have become, in some parts of the world, systemic and intolerant. The individual has lost their place to the mass, and at this moment, our very Earth is facing an environmental crisis never seen before, caused in large part by the dependency on maintaining and increasing numbers by governments, companies, and lobbies around the world. The DP course and much of modern education is dominated by this presence of data and numbers. It is easy to lose yourself in chasing the numbers. It's very easy to lose yourself in chasing numbers at any age, and to forget that while these numbers do matter and are integral to the functioning of our modern civilization, happiness remains, until now, unquantifiable. That is why we are proud. Because this grade never forgot that there is still something more to all of this than those numbers. Our time here has not just been defined by scores. In fact, I can speak honestly and say that it barely was. Teachers, controversial statement, take it how you will. But our time has been marked by our understanding of the importance of two things: a smile and a helping hand.
And that's the best thing about our grade, honestly. You know, in 5 years' time, I don't think I will remember, or anyone will remember, with the grades they got here. In fact, forget the grades. Forget the numbers, because I don't think the numbers, they haven't, and they certainly have never, been the defining character of our grade. I'll be honest, maybe we aren't the most academically oriented cohort in existence, but you know what, who cares? I don't think it takes much of a person to just come in and hunker down and study all the time and work and go home and wake up and work and get that supposed be-all, the IB, all those mythical numbers. And that's not said in malice. I'm absolutely not denigrating the work it takes to get those top marks. I think I can say for the most of the people in attendance here, myself included, how important those numbers are. And I can vouch for how much time and energy and tears we have put into getting those numbers. But in a choice between numbers and humanity, I think we have shown time and time again that we will choose to be kind, honest, and considerate human beings, not robots tripping off in code. A person's defining essence, that je ne sais quoi that makes them them, isn't and shouldn't ever be a number. And I think our grade proves that more than anything else.
So you name it, we've done it. The arts, animal welfare, education, sports. The list goes on and on and on. No matter how stressing and time-consuming the IB was, we still found time to give. We have always understood that as those belonging to a community with so much, it is our duty to extend a helping hand to those who live without the same luxuries as us, and that despite us having our own worries, these should never take precedent over those in greater need. Now, we all know that this cohort loves to have fun. Happiness has never been something we have reserved for ourselves. For us, the smile of another brings just as much, if not more, joy than seeing that 7 on that one paper we did. Everyone deserves to smile. Without our happiness, our lives would simply be a blank canvas, void of any color. And that is why we have never just kept the fun for ourselves.
I'd like to finish with what some of you may call naive optimism. But this is our graduation. And this might be the last time some of us ever see each other. And this is not the time for cynicism. They say that when you look back on your past, all you see is your good, and all the bad has been forgotten and left behind. And maybe I'm speaking only for myself, but I think when I look back, I will see only good, because there was only good. It seems unforgiving when a good thing ends, but this is not the time for cynicism. This is our graduation. This is the last time we may all see each other, the dusk of our brief time here at ISPP. And tomorrow we will see the sun rise on our long years ahead, our many years to come.
But tonight, we are here to celebrate our years together. And we can smile and cheer and scream for what once seemed to be the eternity of our present and future, and will become. Now
only
and our past fondly remember. Thank you.
I think we might just pack up and call it quits, because I'm not sure where we can go from that. What a wonderful speech. A smile and a helping hand, what a great message. What a great way to make a difference. Our first musical performance. In this current grade, we have many, many talented students. I would like to welcome one of them, Haya Iqbal, to the stage where she will perform Count On Me.
Tossing and you're turning and you just can't fall asleep.
was born in Edinburgh, Scotland. At age 5, he and his family moved to Elizabeth in South Australia. Scott dropped out of high school at the age of 16. Not recommended for you, Pepper. And found employment with a drive-in cinema company. He moved up the ladder to film promoter and then to film buyer, eventually becoming managing director of the distribution arm at 20th Century Fox Australia in 1986. Scott immigrated to Los Angeles in 1993 to accept the role of Vice President of International Marketing with 20th Century Fox. He then spent 10 years at 20th Century Fox, culminating in tenure as President of 20th Century Fox International. Scott visited Phnom Penh, Cambodia, during a 5-week vacation in 2003. Whilst there, he visited the Phnom Penh Municipal Dump and met some of the 1,500 children who resided there. In 2004, Scott established the Cambodian Children's Fund. In December 2004, he immigrated permanently to Phnom Penh to manage the organisation. To give you more of Scott's background, we would like to show you this video. Enjoy.
He was the marketing mastermind behind some of Hollywood's biggest blockbusters. Scott Neeson lived the life that some dream of.
It was a great life because I was traveling first class to Paris, Germany, Tokyo, into South America. Had a beautiful house in the hills of Brentwood, and it was a nice life. Had a boat in the harbour and a Porsche SUV, and I loved it.
But the script changed for Scott on a backpacking trip to Cambodia.
I was traumatized myself after the first day there.
It spans 8 football fields. It is 100 feet deep. Its stench carries for miles. And it is where the poorest of Cambodians' desperately poor children eke out a living. This massive garbage dump in Cambodia's capital city offers up scraps of glass and metal these children sell for less than $1 a day.
The children are here because they have nowhere else to go. Many of them have lost their parents, and this dump site is a lifeline for their survival.
Former Hollywood executive Scott Neeson was on vacation when he saw the dump for the first time.
It shattered my world. It was like walking from the best parts of West Los Angeles where I was living to the apocalypse.
Scott's solution, the Cambodian Children's Fund, a safe haven for children. And he did the unthinkable. He left his glamorous life to live in Cambodia.
Today's a garage sale. It's all the stuff I owned from my previous life in the film business. Furniture, they're 300 each.
When you see a child that you found that was in the most appalling circumstances, that had no light in their eyes, and you remember back to the moment you found them, wow, I remember when I found this girl. You can't fathom this was a child once had no light there, because there was just so much joy, so much hope, so much happiness. It was a real honour in being able to not only witness it, but be part of it. That's a real wonderment. People want to matter again. They want to be part of something. They want to be seen as humans, not as a sum total of what they consume. If we can get back to those values, family, love and compassion and tolerance, and away from material goods, then we'll find ourselves again. That's my take. The world according to Scott Neeson.
Please welcome in person Mr. Scott Neeson.
Thank you very much. I should be facing this direction, I think, because this is really, really addressed at you.
Before I begin, Phnom Chimo, I legitimately saw Phnom Chimo Scott Neeson, Phnom Rono Kampuchea, Dabram Chanam, Howie, Phnom Phalang Kampuchea. My name's Scott Neeson. I've been living here for 15 years now. I want to thank Murray, Barry, the Board of Trustees, and everyone else who allowed six of our students from Sting Ming Che to join ISPP. They're the first cohort, the second begin later this year, and as you can imagine, their lives have changed forever. Thank you for that, and thank you for that. And thank you all of you who came and helped us when we had the fire in our community.
To see the world, there's such a lot of world to see. We'll have done the same. Huckleberry friend,
beautiful version of a beautiful song. Congratulations, well done. Even though it's not always about numbers, we do give awards. Now it's time for awards. Our students sitting here on the podium have accomplished many great feats during their time here at ISPP. We would like now to acknowledge some of our Grade 12 award winners. I would like to welcome Ms. Rebecca Chen, our Creativity, Activity and Service Coordinator, to announce the Service Awards. This is Rebecca's last year at ISPP, so I'd like to take this opportunity to thank her for her outstanding efforts over the past 2 years.
Congratulations, graduates. It has taken you guys an awesome year or two to get to where you guys are now, so I'm really proud of you. Can you guys just give your neighbor a really quick hug? So today I'm here to give the ISPP Community and Service Award. This award is presented to a graduate who is recognized for his or her positive character and service to the school and the community. Students are nominated from the graduating class by their teachers, and winners are selected by a committee of teachers and administrators. This year, there are two recipients to the ISPP Community and Service Award. The first is a graduate who is involved in many areas of the ISPP community. She demonstrates a consistent positive character and service to others in and out of the classroom. You would often find her doing a lot of work behind the scenes, whether it is helping her peers with their studies, being the stage manager for the student-led production Blood Wedding, or organizing school functions for the ISPP secondary student body. As the CAS coordinator, I have seen the student thrive in multiple facets. I would like to share a piece of her CAS reflection with you all. Since it is a new year and things were completely new to the new treasurer, I taught her step by step of what to do for events such as the back to school dance. I introduced the system to her as well as share the information I gathered through my last year's work, which hopefully guided her to set prices and quantities of products efficiently. The student ended up volunteering an additional semester of her time in the student council just to ensure her successor had a smooth transition into the role. Described by many of her teachers as being helpful, kind, and extremely talented, she has been a role model to many of her peers. Please help me in congratulating Nana Isoda. Our second recipient is someone who embodies empathy and resilience. From MUN to Career Day Ambassador and assisting in mural wall painting at 111 Kitchen, she is an open-minded and caring individual who spends a lot of her time outside of school serving the community. Notable for being the producer of Blood Wedding and managing a team of over 50 of her peers, she is not only organized and collaborative, but also encouraging and professional, keeping the morale of her team always at a high. Although her two authentic community CAS projects did not spearhead exactly as she had planned, her resilience towards challenges and an unwavering dedication towards serving others are also seen through helping with the clothing drive for CCF's fire donation event and immersing herself in professional workshops such as the United Nations Peace One Day. She is always the first to put her hand up for any opportunity to serve. Her international-mindedness and reflective character is further exemplified in her experience with the scholarship student selection. In her reflection, she writes, "I felt very grateful to be given a chance to contribute in some way. I think these kids have a lot of potential and deserve any chance and help that they can get. It felt like a pivotal moment in the students' lives that we were partaking in, and our words and actions describing their attributes would truly be able to help them get the chance to study and have better opportunities. Please join me in congratulating Watai Diep."
Thank you, Rebecca. I'd like to now welcome our secondary assistant principal, Mr. Jonathan Smeeds, who will present the leadership awards. On a personal note, I'd like to thank the support that Jonathan's given me throughout a trying start to the year, and he's been a rock in secondary, so I thank him for that. But please, for the leadership awards, thank you, Jonathan.
Graduates. Well done. Congratulations on being here today. I have to say that, Alexi and Sammy, you guys were right. Your strength is really in your collective. It's really difficult when I look around and I see the faces of the Ship Award, because many of you have definitely been leaders throughout your time here at ISPP. People who have just put their hands up to come to my office to lead activities, student council, all of the different things that we have going on all the time at ISPP. So in many ways, I see many leaders here today. But as awards often are, there are a chance to highlight just a few. And so today, I have the honor of awarding the Leadership Award, which, like the Community and Service Award, students are nominated from graduating class by their teachers, and winners are selected by committees of teacher and administrators. This year, there's two of you who will be receiving the ISPP Leadership Award. First candidate. Through involvement in many areas of school life, this graduate has demonstrated leadership in a variety of capacities and stands out for ensuring all members of the team have voices, are heard, and are valued. His involvement in the Student Council has spanned many years and included taking a variety of leadership roles to plan activities and events, all of those ones that our students are so welcome and so eagerly attend. He is described by his teachers as articulate, hardworking, and an engine for student advocacy, notable for his roles as Student Council President, Swim Team Captain. Please help me in congratulating Alexei Delang. Our second recipient is a person of many talents, and this graduate has demonstrated leadership through involvement in a variety of activities and in leading special events. The graduate stands out as somebody who is friendly, collaborative, and a deep thinker. Of particular note are her leadership talents within the arts, where she recently directed the student-led production. She has received a one-of-a-kind recognition from the International Schools Theatre Association in being named a young Easter artist, and was instrumental in the success of this year's Easter Festival hosted by ISPP. Congratulations to Daleen Lee. Thank you so much, and congratulations again to our graduates.
Thank you, John. To present our presidential awards for academic excellence, I would like to welcome our IB Diploma Coordinator, Ms. Angelique Hiscox.
My luck to get the one that's only based on numbers. But I would agree with what Alexia and Sammy said as well about, even though we're basing this award on the numbers that a student has achieved over 2 years, it's not just what you've achieved on paper, but you guys have really grown in the 1 year that I've seen you, and that you should be so proud of what you've achieved in the time at ISPP. But based on numbers, the President's Award for Educational Excellence, known as the Gold Award, recognises a student's academic success in the classroom based on the last 2 academic years at ISPP. This year we have 2 recipients. Sure I've got it in the right order? Nope. The first recipient is Shishti Mishra. Recipient is Melissa Tan. Acknowledging that it's not always the total grade point average, we also have the President's Award for Educational Achievement. This award, known as the Silver Award, recognises students who show outstanding educational growth, improvement, commitment, and/or intellectual development in their academic subjects.
This year we have one recipient of the Silver Award. The recipient is Nana Isoda.
Thank you, Angelique. The next awards really are about numbers as well, but more numbers of longevity. I would like to present the Legends of ISPP Awards. These awards are presented to students who have been at ISPP for 10 years or more. It is students such as these who have helped shape our schools, the direction and the culture. The success of ISPP belongs to you as much as to anyone else. Legends, as I call your name, please come to the stage. Boris E. Lim. Sake Ipma. Chilin Law. Rita Chia. Chandra Korea Ing. Alex DeLunga. Syed Siddiq Faham Al Hassani. Timothy Silk. Congratulations. Thank you. You will be missed. We have another special legend. This year, I would also like to present a special Legends Award to a teacher who has been with us for 10 years and is leaving at the end this year. I would please like to welcome Mrs. Lisa Cavill to the stage. Forgetting somebody. Of course, our wonderful director, Mr. Barry Sutherland, finishing his 10 years at ISPP. Well remembered, well loved, and congratulations for all the work you've done here. On the bottom of all our hearts, congratulations on being a legend of ISPP. We also give out some subject awards and director's list awards that appear in the student diploma folders. So rather than ask them to come up on stage, what I would like to do is present them here on a slide. So firstly, the subject awards are given to a student who consistently shows passion for the subject, demonstrates resilience and perseverance in the pursuit of knowledge and skills, and looks to challenge themselves to reach their potential. Congratulations to those students who received the subject award. I did show the students yesterday, so I know you're thinking the people on stage can't see them, but they are aware, so. Secondly is the director's list. To be included on the director's list, a student must receive a total of 36 points for their six subjects, and ensuring they do not receive a score of less than a 4 for any one subject. So each subject has a grade maximum total of 7. So, and they have 6 subjects, so to score a total of 36 or more is quite a feat. So let us acknowledge those students who are included in this year's director's lists. We are now in for a treat. I heard this afternoon before everybody arrived. So I'd like to welcome for our next musical performance, Cameron and Eli with their special version of You've Got a Friend.
Stand in the doorway, don't block the hall, for you get key was stalled. The battle outside and it's raging. Shadow your windows and rattle your walls, for the times they are changing.
Okay, so now we're actually going to get to the main song. So if you know the song, please sing with us.
Your pal said, yeah, you've got a friend in me, because you've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me, you've got a friend in me. You got troubles, I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, we see it through, because you've got a friend in me. Because you've got a friend in me. Some other folks might be a little smarter than I am, bigger and stronger too. Maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way that I do. Just me and you, oh. And as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny, because you've got a friend in me. 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 Because you've got a friend in me.
Thank you, Cameron and Eli. We are getting towards the end. It's now time for the presentation of the diplomas. For the presentation of the diplomas, I now invite Miss Anne Serene Cuckoo on behalf of the Board of Trustees and Mr. Barry Sutherland, our ISPP director, to the stage.
Afternoon. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of the International School of Phnom Penh, all the students presented here for graduation have met the requirements of the ISPP diploma.
Syed Siddiq Faham Al Hussani. Amaya Alvarez Banshi. Dana Andreeva. Leventi Bata. Darwin Bun. Saskia Patrice Capel. Hyunwoo Chang.
Yong Cheng. Rita Chia. Merit Kuku. Alexi Delanga. Watai Deep. Franz Stefan Essiel. Alex Ong. Tianxi Fan. Hana Hayashi. Chan Chakriya Ng. Haya Iqbal. Nana Isoda. Choyun Jung. Aratai Jiratiti Wanakun. Ankita Kabir. Junho Couch. Borisy Lim. Kim Tech Lim. Chilin Law. Darlene Lee. Sreeni Mao. Shristi Mishra. Tekyo Ng. Singheng Noi. Langvit Polra. Kimsi Ping. Sandra Rayton.
Cameron Shapiro. Eli Shapiro. Kunmoni Sivan. Smithy Silk. Sokiva Shrian. Hiroki Sugunhara. Jesse Stone. Melissa Tan. Cinciana Tanabe. Mike Kim Tran. Bao Nok Chong. Monique Van Dalen. Melissa Beng. Maya Yan. Sake Ipma. I'd like to thank Barry and Ansri. Thank you very much. It takes a little while for them to run around the back and get back here, so we'll wait. Congratulations to our graduating class of 2019. Now, given that I am the MC, I do get to have the last word, so bear with me. So, firstly, I would like to thank your parents and guardians for the support they have given our school and for the trust they have placed in our hands to guide you through your time here. Remember, they are your biggest supporters and they always want what is best for you. They feed you, they clothe you, they tell you when to go to bed and love you unconditionally. Please, let's give them a round of applause. Finally, I would like to thank the staff here at ISPP. They have been your teachers, mentors, counselors, and friends. They take great pride in what they do. To have the opportunity of working with people as yourselves is a true joy. It gives us the opportunity not only to impart knowledge and skills, but to add so much more. Like your parents, we want to bring out the best in each of you. We hope that collectively
We have also taught you values that will give you a benchmark as you move through the rest of your life. I would ask that we give a round of applause to all the faculty and workers here at ISPP that have helped you get to know. I would suggest that the greatest value that we could hope to teach you is the value of respect for each other. Respect is a small word, but it encompasses so many things. It includes the ability to actually listen, to listen with empathy, to try and understand someone's viewpoint given their race, culture, background, and values. You are very fortunate in the fact that you have had the opportunity of meeting and working with such a wide variety of people from many different walks of life, and as such, have more of an international understanding. Being respectful also involves the idea of compromise, the ability to place someone else's needs above your own. It involves showing compassion, of truly seeing yourself as one amongst many and acting in accordance. I have seen the respect, compassion, empathy, and kindness in each of you. I recall your collective reaction to the fire in Stungin Chan in March. We've heard about this. It was your group that initiated the collection of donations from the community that resulted in two large truckloads of donations. But that was not enough. Just donating was not enough. You insisted that you had to visit the site of the fire, and it was you that personally handed out the water, food, and clothing to those in need. It's actions such as these that truly make a difference. This is one example of the way in which you have supported our surrounding community, and I would like to applaud your efforts. In closing, I would also like to thank all of the people that have helped put this day together. Our maintenance crew, our wonderful people from the secondary office, Ruxa, Narok, Dila, Saturn, Chris and Adrian from the Black Box, and Sadette and the crew, Rhiannon for the photos, Tom from Retake, who's doing some videoing for us there. I'm bound to have missed somebody, so I'd like to thank you, everybody. Please join me in thanking all the support staff. As we come to the final moments of our ceremony, it is traditional for graduates to move their tassels from the right to the left to indicate the completion of their time here at ISPP. Graduates, please move your tassels. And finally, I would like to welcome our graduates to the stage for their final performance.
Together, 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 together
proceedings. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. Thank you very much.